Favorite vacation spot. Everyone has their own idea of what makes a great getaway, including our own Neil Jones, and he has tonight's top five. It's summertime
when millions of Americans hit the roads and the airports to embark on their family vacations. The Jones family went to Europe this summer, where we learned several important lessons. There's no Mexican food in Spain, no swimsuit tops in Italy.
I can't show you those pictures.
And the most important lesson, not every iconic tourist attraction is worth the effort.
But that's also true here in the United States.
So here are my top five overrated tourist attractions. Number five, Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. My wife and I honeymooned there for the golf and the beach, and they were good. But everything else was a disappointment.
They call it the Redneck Riviera for a reason.
Now, there are great miniature golf courses and strip clubs there.
But I hate mini golf, and I don't go to strip clubs.
Yeah, right.
I really don't. And the nightlife? It's a bunch of 80-year-olds chasing 60-year-olds.
Number four, Pat's Cheesesteaks in Philadelphia. We made the mistake of going to Pat's earlier this summer, and it was 90 minutes of waiting, followed by 10 minutes of bad food. Look how happy we are. Now, Pat's is always packed with tourists. What you won't see there are Philadelphians. They eat at Tony's.
So when in Philadelphia, do not follow the tourists.
Number three, Venice Beach, California. My boss, who's a former college football player, loved to show off his muscles at the beach. Any beach, except on Venice Beach. He reports that Venice is famous for homeless men and the smell of urine.
My Missouri relatives tell me that that reminds them of Allen Fieldhouse.
Like most California beaches, Venice is overrun by tourists. It all adds up to a major disappointment. Number two, Mount Rushmore. Now, wait a minute, Mount Rushmore? For 78 years now, it's been a symbol of our nation's strength and spirit. It's attracted thousands of American families who gaze up at the 60-foot-tall granite faces of four of our nation's greatest men.
Yep, you stare at it for 2.5 minutes, and then you wonder, what do we do next?
And that's the problem. There's very little else to see or do there. Now, including Mount Rushmore on this list is Ellen McNamara's idea. As a young child, she went there with her mom, who was hit on by an elderly park ranger.
Who might have been considered a bit of a dirty old man.
So maybe her feelings about the place have been skewed a bit. And the number one most overrated tourist attraction, the Gateway Arch. Yes, it's iconic, and yes, it is beautiful. Like my first girlfriend, the arch looks a lot better from a distance than it does from up close. I've only been up inside the arch once, and that was one time too many. It was hot, cramped, and smelled bad.
My Kansas relatives say that that reminds them of Mizzou Arena.
My favorite arch memory is about the Cardinal fans who vowed to jump off it if the Redbirds lost to the Royals in the 85 World Series.
I'm still waiting.
I'm Neil Jones, and those are my top five most overrated tourist attractions.